The heart of any planting operation is really creating the seed furrow, and to do that on modern planters today, why it involves use of a double disc seed opener. On many planters, such as the Kinze that we have here today, or say a Deere or white, we've got an evenly matched double disc seed opener. And when I say evenly matched, right at the soil entry point, there's some blade contact, or there should be some blade contact there. If you think about this being a clock dial here, down here at about that 4 o'clock position, we need to have probably about 1¼ inches, maybe 1½ inches of blade contact. One fairly quick, easy way to check that is to take someone's business card. We'll just insert here. You should be able to probably slip that in about the 2 or 3 o'clock position. But when you get down here into that 4 o'clock position, it should be fairly snug there, right through there, you know, pretty tightly pinched together. I've got just a little loose at the moment because we've kind of loosened things up here, but that's a way that one can check it. Of course, the beveled edges of these double disc seed openers do wear with time, and there is an adjustment available to reestablish that blade contact. Again, you want nice, smooth slicing ability both through the soil and any residue that might be present, say in a no-till type situation. To make the change here and reestablish that blade contact, there's a set of spacer washers behind each of these double disc seed openers. We're going to work on the right side of this seed opener here. To do this, we've got our planter mechanically blocked up here while we're working on it. And I've got things kind of loosened up here, but first of all, we'll remove the depth gauging wheel on the right side here, and there's some spacer washers on the outside here as I remove this attachment bolt. See if I can keep the washer still from all falling. Here, but I've removed those, and then we'll slip off the depth gauging wheel and set it down here off to the side. Stick our bolt and washers there. Then we've got a scraper here. We've got a fixed linear scraper here. You may see a rotary scraper. I've got things kind of partially loosened up here, one bolt off and the other one kind of loosened up here, but I'll loosen that up, kind of rotate that up, so we can get that up out of the way as needed. Then we'll have a dust cover over our bearing here. I'm gonna slip that dust cover off. Now I'll expose a bolt head and we'll loosen that up. I'm working on the right side of the row unit now, so these have common right-handed threads on that, but if I was over on the left side of the seed opener here, they actually have left-handed threads there to keep that colder from loosening up while it's operating in the field. But I'm going to slip my hand down here because there's some spacer washers that might drop as I take this off. But let's see if I can get that worked off here. And there we go. There's our coulter off, and it looks like we've got a couple of spacer washers. See if I can kind of slip those. Two spacer washers basically back behind there, and again, if we didn't have that blade contact up front, we'd remove those one by one, take one of those spacer washers off from the inside, move it to the outside basically on the attachment bolt. And then reattach here, and that's what we'll do. While we're in here though, do take a look. We've got a furrow firming point that kind of guards our seed drop tube here. It's another replacement wear item. Ordinarily is not replaced probably until you've got enough wear on both these double disc seed openers to replace those, but you can check that too while you're in here to give her kind of a general inspection for wear there, and of course up on the scraper. But again, we've moved a washer from inside to outside if needed. And we'll see if we can mount this back up here. And again, I'm just going to put her in snug for right now for demonstration purposes, but move it torque that back up where it needs to be. Put on our desk cover. Get that scraper back in position. I'll tighten up this bolt or snug this one up, and of course we'll be putting that second one in. Again, two. After we did that, why then we would go on ahead and put our depth gauging wheel, remount that. And if we moved a spacer washer from inside to outside on the coulter, on the double disc seat opener, we probably are going to do that or consider doing that on the spacer washers on the attachment arm on this depth gauging wheel also. Again, what you want to do is you want to keep that depth gauging wheel up basically just flush, if you will, against the inside of that depth gauging wheel with the outside of the coulter on the double disc seat opener. Anyways, of course, we'd snug that up again, retorque that, and that's the adjustment. Really fairly simple, but an important part of establishing that seed furrow, really for any planting operation, but particularly as we start to think about planting into high residue or reduced tillage systems.